Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys how to keyframe a little saturation on the color page to go from black and white to full color. So what you're going to do is make a new node, Option S. If you don't see your keyframes, normally your view is the scopes down here. There's a little diamond next to that is your keyframe viewer. And one other thing, there's a little checkbox arrow right here to open and expand. If you noticed when I first clicked on scopes, if this is open and you click over to scopes, scopes will take up more real estate and you'll lose some of your tools over here. And you can't reset that unless you go back to the keyframe, close that up, and then hit the scopes one more time. So go back to keyframes. I do like to keep it open when I'm working with keyframes just to have a little more screen. And since we're on node number one or O1, it's going to be corrector one. You can hit the little drop down arrow here. We're going to choose color corrector. And where our playhead is, this is where we want full saturation. We can right click. Say add dynamic keyframe. Now sometimes it just adds a single, so you're gonna have to pay attention to what it looks like. Right click it again and then hit add dynamic keyframe, and you should see these little arrows that indicate movement over time with your keyframe. Now sometimes it gets a little finicky until you give it some parameters, so I'm going to click that keyframe. It turns red, and that's sort of saying snapshot with the state it's in now. Then you can use your left and right brackets to go to your next keyframes. So now we're on this one. I'm going to click it and pull our saturation down. You can see the change in the window. Then if we play, it goes rather quickly from black and white. Then you can lasso those keyframes and kind of move it over. I'm going to park the first keyframe right over the start of the shot and let go. Then I'll grab the right and drag it. And that just extends the time duration on it. It's been a little finicky a few times here, but now that that's established, you can drag it around and it'll work. And that's how you can automate a black and white to color dissolve in the color page. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you guys on the next video.